Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1708, Chandoo Structured References. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We're here in Akron, Ohio, and guess who is here from halfway around the world? That's right, it's Chandoo here to do a guest appearance on the Mr. Excel podcast. Let me turn it over to Chandoo.
Hey, Bill. So glad to be here, and I'm totally excited to be talking to your community and sharing one of the most time-saving tips that I ever came across. Okay, so this is called as creating tables. Let's say you are looking at some data like this, and this is some data that Bill throwed in. So it has some regions, products, dates, customer quantity, revenue, COGS, and profit, and we have a few hundred rows of that. Now, one of the common things that happens in business world is your data is never static. Every month, every week, every day, you're adding new data, right? So that's one of the things. So the second thing is any formulas or charts or any of those things that you build on top of this, they need to keep this in mind that the data is going to grow. Sometimes it might even change. So one of the things that people often do is when they want to sum up the total quantity sold, they would write something like sum of, and then let's say it starts on E2 and goes all the way up to, so that's E564, right? So they would put something like E2 to E564. Or if I want to make sure that the new data is considered, sometimes people might even say E1000 or E10000 or E100000. But this kind of approach is not good because you might have something else at the bottom, like in this case, we have some text. Of course, it's not in that column, but it is still there. And the second thing is it might just unnecessarily keep Excel busy. And this is where tables come in really handy. So you just go into any cell inside the data and press Ctrl+T, T for table. And make sure the first row has the headers and you check that and then click OK. So instantly Excel would format the whole thing as a table and then you have this set up as a table. Now take a minute and look at this. A table is not just a formatting thing, but even from a formatting perspective, it is really pretty looking, right? Every other row is shaded in a different color, filters are applied on top automatically, and you can easily scan this when you are looking for information. When you select a table, a new ribbon would appear here. This is called design ribbon, and a table is given a name by default, table 1, 2, or 29, like that. Let's just select this and say my sales, right? And then keep in mind that the table name has to be changed from the design tab. Now you want to sum up the total quantity, you would just write a simple formula that says sum of my sales quantity. And that's it. Not only this formula would work for all the quantity values in your sales table, this formula is so easy to write. You don't have to look at E2 to E564 or any of those kind of references. You just refer to the data by its structure. So this is what I call Excel is calling as structural references as against relative or absolute references, right? So you can use this, and the moment you add any data at the end of the table, just remember that number. It's 313900. And let's go and add up a new quantity here that is for 1000. Okay, and when you press enter, the table formatting gets extended and your formula gets recalculated, so you would get the new number there. So this is how easy it is to set up table formatting and then calculate. Not just formulas, even if you set up a chart on top of table, any additions to the table gets reflected in the chart automatically, right? Not just charts and formulas. If you create a pivot table from the table, then the pivot table is connected to a table. So I'll just show you very quickly. You select something and you insert a pivot table. You would see that the selection range for that actually refers to here as my sales. It's not saying A1 to K240 or something like that. It says I'm going to create a pivot from my sales table. The advantage of that is when your data changes, all you have to do is refresh your pivot table. You don't have to modify a source data connection or any of that. Apart from these, there are many advantages of table, and I'm sure Bill has covered several of these in his podcasts. But if you need to learn a little more, you could check my MrExcel.com, or you can even go to Chandoo.org and look up some information. So I hope you like it, and I hope to catch up with you once again sometime soon. Bye-bye.
All right, hey, that's cool, the structured table. I remember when, you know, tables were originally not just Ctrl+T, but back in Excel 2003, they were Ctrl+L, and I said, this is silly. All it is formatting, but it's not the formatting. It's the fact that as the table grows, the formulas grow, the charts grow, the pivot tables grow. And even if you already have a pivot table that's not based on a table, and you go Ctrl+T that range and then add more data, the pivot table will automatically grow. It's retroactive. So a great tip. I want to thank Chandoo for stopping by. And I want to thank everyone else for checking us out. We'll see you tomorrow for another netcast from Mr. Excel.